Spicy MedTech here, and this video will be the first video of a new series I will be doing for useful mobile applications when it comes to productivity in academics. And in today's video, I will be reviewing and teaching you how to use a flashcard app that uses the principle of spaced repetition. If you don't know what spaced repetition is, it's basically a learning technique that needs learners to repeat harder to learn information more often and easier to learn information less often. This app is called Anki. For Android, it's called Anki Droid Flashcards. And for iOS, it's called Anki Mobile Flashcards. Links will be in the description box down below. So once you open the app, it's going to look a little something like this. I'm currently using the version for Android, but the iOS version does not differ much. Now I'm going to teach you how to use this app. Say you have an exam coming up for clinical chemistry. So we tap the Add button here at the lower right and click Create Deck. Let's name it Clinical Chemistry. As you can see, a deck named Clinical Chemistry has been added to the main interface. Tap it. And again, let's tap the Add button once more and press Add. Here, we could choose the type of flashcard we want. The basic card that only shows you the question, and when you flip a basic card, it will show the answer. The reversible card, which will show you either the question or the answer. Or the type card that will require you to type the answer. Let's start with a basic card and let our question be the most potent estrogen. Let's key in our answer here below, which is estradiol. You may add pictures or voice clips here at the side, but let's not bother with that for now. Now that's done, let's tap this check mark here at the upper right corner. Let's go back and try it out. So we try to answer in our mind. And once that's done, we flip the card, and there's your answer. And here at the bottom, we are given three choices: red, green, and blue. Following the principle of spaced repetition, if you get it wrong, tap the red card. The app will make sure that the question is repeated to you more often. If you tap the green card, means you know it only moderately and will repeat it in a while. And if you tap the blue card, which means you got the answer right, the app will repeat it to you in a few days. Let's go back and try out a reversed card. Go to Add and change basic to basic and reversed card. Let's key in the wavelength of cyan-met hemoglobin, and down here we key in 540 nanometers. Tap Add and let's try it out. If you get it wrong, press the red button as you can see here. The question will just keep on getting repeated and repeated. But if you press either the green or the blue, it's going to repeat it after a longer time when you want to review it again. Let's go back one more time to try a typed question. Tap Add, then change Basic to Basic type in the answer. And let's go with the reference laboratory for clinical chemistry. Key in Lung Center of the Philippines here at the bottom. Tap Add, and let's go try it out. Let's key in Lung Center of the Philippines and see what happens. As you can see, it marks as a correct answer. Let's try one more time, but this time, let's see what happens if we just type in Lung Center. The words that we got correct are marked as green, and the words we didn't get are marked as gray. And since we got Lung Center of the Philippines correct earlier, let's tap the blue button since we know the answer. And then the app will clear you of studying, indicating that you know the flashcards well and is only going to repeat it a few days from now, following the principle of spaced repetition. I do recommend doing this daily. Set aside about 15 to 30 minutes a day and make it part of your daily routine until the information becomes close to second nature. So that will be all for now. I will be back with more productivity and academic apps soon. Stay safe. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed.